How much?
About 30 million, Mr. Rourke.
30 million-isk?
Yes, sir.
That's practically a new ship.
Clear Skies will practically be a new ship when she's fixed, sir.
But I don't want a new ship. I want this one back as it was.
There isn't, frankly, much left of the current vessel. Perhaps sir shouldn't have got it quite so badly damaged.
Hey, I didn't damage it. I wasn't the one shooting at it. Believe me, I was trying to avoid the damage.
Alas, sir, the damage didn't avoid you, and the repairs stand at 30 million isk.
Why don't I just strap an armour repair on and go clog up the outside of the station? That doesn't cost 30 million.
Sir, as I have explained already, it's not just the armour. Your superstructure is in dire need of reinforcing and renovation, as well as most of the internal systems.
Yeah, I know what you said. Still, at least if I'm paying that much, you'll have it ready fast, right?
3 weeks, sir.
How long?
Have they fixed it yet?
Try to quell your surprise, Charlie, but they have in fact finally finished welding Clear Skies back together. Jump up and clap hands with glee.
Oh, will miracles never cease?
It's hardly a miracle. They didn't take this long even after that Amarian slave trader shot the top wingy bit off a couple of years back.
Top wingy bit?
Well, hull breaches will do that to a ship's internal structure. Now, on to the more pressing matter of cash flow.
It's got a proper name, you know.
Yeah, the target.
Basically, we have no cash, and thus no flow.
So pretty much the last few years of grubbing around and getting our asses shot off as a manager to us sat here, bored to skin and with no charter. Champion, all we own is a ship that looks like an explosion in a girder factory.
Well, yeah, that and the tales to tell in the bars. Come on, you mustn't forget them. Anyway, with a fully refitted ship, we can look for a charter. And I've got good news and bad news on that front.
Oh, I?
Yeah, the good news is I've got some idiot in a shiny suit. He wants ferrying 9 jumps across the fringes of Empire Space, and he only wants to go in a battleship-class vessel, which means we feature highly in his plans, especially as you don't normally get them docked around here. And he's also willing to pay 30 million quid.
How much?
Flat kind of cash he could buy his own ship.
Exactly, which brings us to the bad news.
Which is?
Some idiot in a shiny suit is willing to pay massively over the odds to get ferried 9 jumps through Empire Space and apparently needs a battleship to do it, which can only mean one thing.
It's a death trap.
It's a death trap.
So what else is there available?
Some job-shifting cans of quaff about in-system for not enough money to even charge the capacitor, and that really is it. Seems like we picked the worst place to hole up in 10 jumps, but what with the ship's lack of ability to hold air in at the time, I guess we can't complain. Face it, lads, we don't really have a lot of choice. Either sell Clear Skies and go back to a cruiser, try and work our way back up again like the bad old days, or take on the death trap job.
We've only just had this ship put back into one piece. Paint isn't dry yet. I don't want to scratch the moment we undock, okay?
I'll take that as a vote for the trap of death. Charlie?
Oh, I'm gunnery. I don't care. Probably means that once again I'll be justifying my place on board.
What, you mean like the last time? How quickly we forget.
Right, sorted then. I'll contact the shiny suited idiot and tell him he's got a place on our ship. Then I'll check the insurance. Yes, sir.
Since when have we ever had insurance?
Since when indeed?
Okay, I've discussed it with my crew, and I'm happy to say you've got a place on our ship, Mr...
You can call me Mr. Smith.
Huh, and here we are, thousands of years down the line since Eve Day 1, and yet people still use Mr. Smith when wishing to remain anonymous.
Possibly I use it because that is my name.
Yeah, well, as long as the fund's clear, you can call yourself Eleanor Gatsky as far as I'm concerned.
The funds will clear. Half now, half on arrival. Standard Metropolis contract terms.
Assuming we make it intact. What's the destination?
The system of Heck, unfortunately.
Okay, Sol, you got that?
Yep. Heck, you say? Right, let's have a shafty. Hedion, Hemen, Heck, there it is. Looks like it's about 10 jumps from here. That's about an hour.
Excellent. Can we leave right away?
Sure, I can't see why not.
You have a sofa on the bridge of a ship. That's very eccentric.
Yeah, well, this ship's pretty much my home, and I'm not one for holing up in cabins. I like to sit out here and look at the stars.
As someone holed up in an office for most of the time, I can understand that.
If you like the sofa that much, you can have it in your office for 200.
Hey, what have I
told you before about trying to sell my sofa, Burke?
You're right. You can have it for nothing.
Alas, my office is far too small for such an artifact. And on that note, gentlemen, I shall retire to my cabin and take some medication. Warp drive does affect my stomach, so, and I prefer to sleep through it.
Righto, let's get undocked and see what bits fall off the ship.
Clear skies, this is Station CNC. You are go for undock and warp.
Roger that, CNC.
And I'll see you later in the contract pages.
You got it, John. Try and bring it back intact next time. Station out.
That's odd. Yeah, everything looks sort of... Oh, they must have cleaned the windows or something.
They are undocked. The cargo is on board. They are on their way to you.
You know, I just don't know why Smith has a problem. I mean, how can gate travel upset you, Storm?
Warp drive active.
So, to my surprise, everything's working first go.
That's a first.
Yeah, looks like these repairs were money well spent and they took the time commissioning it all correctly. You should remember the place that did this. Except, of course, the light above my console's flickering.
I thought you said everything was working first go.
Well, the major systems, yes, but we've still got dodgy lights.